Kuala Lumpur Reuters Kim Jang Nam, the murdered half-brother of North Korea's leader, had a dozen vials of antidote for lethal nerve agent VX in his sling bag on the day he was poisoned, a Malaysian court was told this week. Two women, Indonesian Siti and Doan, a Vietnamese, are charged with conspiring with four North Korean fugitives in the murder, making use of banned chemical weapon VX at the Kuala Lumpur International Airport on February 13. The vials contained atropine, an antidote for poisons such as VX and insecticides, toxicologist Dr. K. Sharmila told the court on Wednesday, state news agency Bernama said. However, she did not know if the vials were marked in Korean, she said when cross-examined by Siti Aisyah's lawyer, Goi Soon-sang. Kim Jang-nam, who was living in exile in Macau, had criticized his family's dynastic rule of North Korea and his brother had issued a standing order for his execution, some South Korean lawmakers have said. Malaysia was forced to return Kim Jang-nam's body and allow the suspects hiding in the embassy to return home, in exchange for the release of nine Malaysians barred from leaving Pyongyang. A reporter holds up a local newspaper during his report in front of the morgue at Kuala Lumpur General Hospital where Kim Jang Nam's body is held for autopsy in Malaysia February 18, 2017. Reuters Safit Parawang Methane Thursday, a police witness told the court Huong had the opportunity to dispose of a t-shirt and short skirt she had worn during the alleged attack. The t-shirt, bearing the word LOL, and the skirt could have easily been found in a pile of clothes in the hotel room where Huong stayed. The witness, Nazra Al-Sain Hamza, an assistant superintendent, told Huong's lawyer, Hisiam Th Po Take. Indonesian Siti Aisyah and Vietnamese Doan T Huong, who are on trial for the killing of Kim Jang Nam, the estranged half-brother of North Korea's leader, are escorted as they revisit the Kuala Lumpur International Airport to Insepang, Malaysia October 24, 2017. Reuters Lay Seng Tsin earlier, Nasrallah told the court that he needed Huong to point out the clothes, which had been concealed when the police raided. Defense lawyers say Siti Aisyah and Huong, arrested in Kuala Lumpur within days of the killing, were duped into thinking they were playing a prank for a reality TV show and did not know they were poisoning Kim Jang Nam. North Korea has denied accusations by South Korean and U.S. officials that Kim Jong Un's regime was behind the killing. The court hearings, which have run more than a month, are to resume on January 22. Reporting by Joseph Sipalin, editing by Clarence Fernandez or Standards D. Thompson, Reuters Trust Principles.